Close your ears if you wanted Granit Xhaka to go. Close your ears if you dislike Granit Xhaka, because I could have some bad news for you. I definitely have some bad news for you. Open your ears, smile if you wanted Granit Xhaka to stay, because your dream has come true. Mikel Arteta has been asked after the game the situation on Granit Xhaka. Will he stay? Will he leave? And he's actually confirmed that Granit Xhaka, yes, Granit Xhaka will stay with Arsenal this season. Now, that to me is, I do not understand that decision. I absolutely do not understand that solution for that transfer. I know Roma wanted to give us around 13, 12 million for him. I definitely agree that that is very, very little. We should be getting at least 20 million for him. But Roma have decided not to go for him, and there's no other team that wants Granit Xhaka. And can you say we are keeping him because he's good, or will we say that we are keeping him because there's no other team that wants him? And that is a very, very huge worry. Now, against Chelsea came on and he scored the equalizer, very good header. But right after that, forget about the Bellerin mistake that you were supposed to pass to Xhaka. Xhaka gave out the ball in such a dangerous position again. I saw him committing a couple of fouls. We've seen Granit Xhaka committing a couple of fouls before. Again. And it's the same inconsistency again and again and again. We all know he can have a very, very magnificent free kick from nowhere and he scores in a derby or something. And we're like, wow, Granit Xhaka is back. But we also know that he can make a mistake anytime. He can cost you the game anytime. He can lose his head anytime. He can pick up a red card. He can give out a foul. He can give out a penalty anytime. That's the one thing I do not like about him. And why I'm surprised that he's going to stay is, I think right now, maybe a couple of seasons ago, 50% still wanted him to stay, 50% wanted him to go. But at the moment, I actually think like 80% wanted him to go and 20% wants him to stay. And I also don't think he wants to stay at Arsenal. I think he's had so much abuse. I think it's just good for him to try something new. He's been here for almost 5 years now, almost 6 years now. I would have thought he wanted to try something new, go to Italy, try a new adventure for him. So for him to stay, that to me is very, very surprising. And does he deserve to stay? Listen, last season, especially in terms of covering for the left back, I think we do not have anyone else who can do that. But that's why the transfer market is open. Try and get someone new who can actually do that. Do not go for the same players that we've had all those years. Granit Xhaka is staying. Bellerin, I've always said that I think he's actually going to stay. Cedric is still here. Chambers is still here. Elneny is still here. Kolasinac is still here. Ranason is still here. Basically, Nketi is still here. Willock is still here. Nelson is all the same players we had. They're all still here. We have the Premier League season for us starts in how many days? Like 12 days. Now, if you're going to tomorrow, we'll have 11 days to get our game ready. We need to get our game ready very soon. How fast can they do transfers for these players to come up to come and have an impact at Arsenal? I do not think they actually need to do that. I actually don't think they're going to do that, unfortunately. Now, we are going to be in a lot of trouble if we have to rent. I actually forgot about Willian as well. We are actually going to stay with these players for next season again, which really, really worries me. Now, the moment Thomas Partey went down with the injury, I knew right then Xhaka will stay, because it's only Lokonga and Partey and Elneny that we have at the club right now. I'm not sure I trust Elneny 100% in terms of starting games. And Partey injury prone, unfortunately. I've just done a video talking about what we learned from the Chelsea game. And the first thing I talked about was Partey's injuries. It really concerns me. So the moment he went down, I'm thinking what they thought was, you know what? This guy, if he gets injured and we only have Elneny and Lokonga, will that be enough? I don't think so. So they've decided to actually keep Xhaka, because he was asked right after the game what's the situation with Xhaka, and he actually gave an answer instantly. He's going to stay. So Granit Xhaka survives yet again now. Let me know in the comment section, do you think Granit Xhaka would have survived if he was like at a Liverpool or a City? Do you think you'd have stayed in those clubs for this long? I always like freshness in the team. I do not like a player staying in a team for more than 6, 7 years. I know back in the days, the likes of Adams, John Terry, Lampard, all of them stayed in their teams for years, the likes of Paul Scholes and all of them. But right now, you just need to keep rotating, add some freshness here and there. Do not stay the same team, because it becomes too comfortable for these players. But hey, Granit Xhaka stays. Partey got injured. We lost to Chelsea. How things turn. The other day, we were celebrating a Smith Rowe contract, celebrating White signing. Today, it's right back to reality again, unfortunately. So, let me know in the comment section what you think about that. Would you have sold him? Do you think he deserves to stay? Do you think you're being unfair on Granit Xhaka? Do you think other people make mistakes and it's just not just him? Let me know different opinions on him. But as of now, Granit Xhaka has been confirmed to be staying at Arsenal. Another season of him again. Thank you for watching. Keep staying safe, and I'll catch up with you guys later.
Thank you.